let me start with talking about building that high performance culture in a let's say in a startup environment. Now, interestingly, you know, this is something we experience within my current organization in many different ways. You know, depending purely on the business, or we're looking at creating a new product, or when it comes to the strategies for you know, go to market, to what happens, how do we really operationalize it? So I think first and foremost, what comes out very clearly is that do people have a very clear understanding of their objectives? What is to be done? What is expected of them? And the teams actually getting together and defining based on whatever may have been agreed as a, you know, initial business plan, what they were going to accomplish. So that is obviously the larger context. But within that, each one is very clear about their specific roles and responsibilities, what is expected of them, and the fact that on an ongoing basis, you know, you're reviewing, you're revisiting, you're seeing exactly where you are, you know, where you stand, what are the gaps, what are the areas that are moving well, what are the areas where maybe there is need for additional focus. Okay, and since we all know we are operating in such a dynamic environment, how frequently do you do that? What degree of honesty and openness with which you, you know, carry out frequent team reviews? That is what helps in setting very clear priorities when it comes to the team. Also, within the team, you're constantly, you know, contracting, you're encouraging, helping each other, actually. You are in a supportive role, and that is where the team leaders obviously play a very key part, because that is then, this is when it becomes a sort of a performance culture, you know, for the team. Let's take it to now a larger setup where you have, you know, virtual teams, where you have teams that, business teams that have to work with their support teams, elements of cross-functional leadership, you know, they come in. How do you make sure that if the teams are not in one location, would you still be able to make sure that the understanding around priorities, understanding around deliverables, fact that everybody has one common project plan? And we know that one common project plan doesn't necessarily always contribute to achieving those goals together. And I think that is where the team leadership and each of the members in the team, in fact, I would say that it is the idea of ownership here that sometimes counts far more than saying, you know, who are the leaders, people in the formal roles of leaders. It is ownership then which is likely to drive. So it's almost like you're talking about a, you know, PCMM level 5 situation. Teams are aware, individuals are aware what they need to do. They are seamlessly working with each other. They are seamlessly transcending, you know, whatever boundaries or perhaps barriers would be the right word. That is when you say that you're actually working towards or you're building a high performance culture. So some nuances don't change very clearly. The fundamentals don't change. I think it's the ability of the team members and the leaders to look beyond their own, I shouldn't say limited, but they have to be able to look beyond their noses and then be able to, you know, work towards the goals and objectives as a team.